What's element 115?
Element 115 is a super heavy element. It's something that we only just recently synthesized. We only made 4 atoms of it. But the craft uses larger quantities of it, 223 gram little triangles of it. But it's a unique element. When it's exposed to radiation, it produces its own gravitational field.
Finally, after years of speculation and secrecy, Dr. Michio Kaku has unveiled the discovery of alien element 115, long concealed from public knowledge. The implications of this revelation are nothing short of extraordinary, promising to redefine our understanding of the cosmos and our place within it. What secrets does element 115 hold about extraterrestrial life? And how will this newfound knowledge reshape humanity's quest for answers beyond our planet? Join us as we delve into the implications of this groundbreaking revelation by Michio Kaku. Before we delve in, make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already so you can stay updated on our upcoming great content. In the late 1980s, Robert Scott Lazar, an American known for his association with conspiracy theories, claimed he worked on analyzing advanced extraterrestrial technology at a site called S4 near Area 51 in Nevada. He stated that he was involved in studying 9 unidentified flying objects, which he referred to as flying saucers. Among these crafts, he highlighted one he called the Sport Model, allegedly powered by a mysterious substance known as Element 115. Lazar claimed that Element 115 allowed these saucers to perform extraordinary maneuvers, seemingly defying the laws of physics. He described S4 as a highly secretive facility where teams worked on various classified projects. Lazar didn't just claim to have seen UFOs, he provided detailed accounts of his involvement, including technical specifications, locations, and timelines. His stories captivated those curious about what the government might be hiding regarding extraterrestrial encounters. However, not everyone believed Lazar's accounts. Scientists like Michio Kaku questioned his educational background and the credibility of the places he mentioned. The scientific community also doubted his claims about Element 115 and its supposed role in interstellar travel. Before Lazar, Area 51 was simply a secretive military base, but he turned it into a hotspot for alien-related stories. His status as a whistleblower brought attention to Area 51 and portrayed him as a hero challenging government secrecy. Despite facing criticism and ridicule, Lazar's story left a lasting impression. It encouraged other whistleblowers to come forward with similar revelations about secret government operations and encounters with the unknown. Thanks to Lazar, the UFO discussion evolved from whispers and blurry images to a more vocal and public discourse. Bob Lazar described the S4 facility near Groom Lake, Nevada, as a secret and heavily guarded place where research on alien technologies happens. He claimed it was not just a storage site for alien artifacts, but also housed working flying saucers with advanced abilities. These saucers were supposedly hidden in hangars within the mountainside, suggesting a high level of secrecy. Lazar said that Element 115 was key to these spacecraft's propulsion systems, creating a gravity field that allowed them to move in ways that defied conventional physics. According to him, this element was brought to a secret facility for experiments. When placed in a spacecraft reactor, it created a gravity wave that helped the ship take off and move very fast. Lazar's story sparked both interest and skepticism. Some believe S4 is a place of groundbreaking discoveries, while others think it's all fiction. If Lazar's claims are true, it would mean that the US government or a secret group possesses technology far beyond what we know. It also suggests the possibility that we are not alone in the universe and that our governments might be hiding extraterrestrial artifacts. This idea leads to intense debates. The controversy around Lazar's story involves the complexity of alien technology, Element 115, and S4's operations. Talking about S4 and Element 115 makes people curious, hopeful, and skeptical about finding extraterrestrial truth. It's not just about space. It's also about potential government secrets. Kaku pointed out that big claims like Lazar's naturally face scrutiny. Critics questioned Lazar's education and the existence of S4. Some couldn't find records of his time at MIT and Caltech, and others doubted the existence of S4 as he described it. The physics community also doubted Element 115's role in propulsion, saying it contradicted known physics laws. When muscovium, also known as element 115, was created and studied, it was found to be unstable and unsuitable for powerful energy use in propulsion. There were doubts about Bob Lazar's explanation of alien craft workings, particularly regarding gravity waves. Physicists like Michio Kaku found his descriptions lacking the expected detail for someone with advanced physics training. The concept of gravity waves seemed unfamiliar and conflicting with what's known about element 115. Some suggested the stable isotope Lazar mentioned might not have been discovered or was kept secret. They argued that our understanding of elements and isotopes evolves, so what's impossible now might be explained later. Many saw Lazar's willingness to face criticism as adding credibility to his claims, showing his belief in them despite challenges. The debate over Lazar's revelations mirrors broader discussions on UFOs and alien life. Skeptics demand solid proof, while believers trust evidence, intuition, and a sense of not being alone. Some remain open to possibilities, awaiting undeniable proof. Lazar's story, with convincing details yet confusing aspects, will likely stay controversial in UFO history. The internet has made Lazar's story a global topic, sparking curiosity and debates about our cosmic place. Scientists have scrutinized Lazar's claims, especially about element 115, within scientific frameworks. Lazar asserted element 115 powered alien craft he allegedly saw, creating a gravity field for space-time control and interstellar travel. Yet, scientists noted issues with this claim. Element 115, or muscovium, entered the periodic table in 2003 but was highly unstable, breaking down quickly. Its instability made it an unlikely energy source, let alone for space travel. Lazar's claim that element 115 could control gravity intrigued physicists. Gravity is a fundamental force in nature, but controlling it has proven extremely difficult despite extensive research. The idea that a substance like element 115 could influence gravity contradicts current scientific understanding. While science is always open to new ideas, claims need to be supported by evidence through experiments or observations that others can verify. There is no strong evidence supporting Lazar's claims about element 115's extraordinary abilities. Notably, Lazar did not publish his ideas in reputable journals or collaborate with other scientists to validate them. In science, peer review and collaboration are crucial for establishing the credibility of new claims. Lazar's story, while captivating, requires solid proof to be believed. So far, we lack that proof. To verify or refute claims about element 115, we need rigorous scientific investigation, not just anecdotal stories. Discussions about government secrets and advanced technology often lead to speculation about official cover-ups. When Lazar made his claims about secret bases and advanced tech, the government initially did not respond, fueling more speculation. Believers saw the silence as a sign of a larger conspiracy, while skeptics viewed it as the government ignoring baseless accusations. Investigations into Lazar's academic credentials from institutions like MIT and Caltech resulted in denials from these schools, leading some to suspect a cover-up and further skepticism about Lazar's narrative. The US Air Force, which oversees Area 51, maintained secrecy about its operations, fueling more speculation. Former employees and contractors at Area 51 did not explicitly endorse Lazar's claims, but hinted at highly classified projects at the facility, contributing to the culture of secrecy. In 2013, the CIA officially acknowledged the existence of Area 51 in a declassified report on the U-2 spy plane program. However, this acknowledgement did not support Lazar's claims about extraterrestrial technologies. Despite varied governmental responses, denial, admission, or silence, finding the truth remains challenging. Lazar's statements fluctuate between credibility and doubt, and the government's reactions add complexity to the narrative. Meanwhile, investigative journalist Michael Schellenberger reported that intelligence officials identified 30 aircraft not made by humans, supporting whistleblower David Grush's claims about non-human vehicles.
If you believe we have crashed craft, stated earlier, do we have the bodies of the pilots who piloted this craft?
As I've stated publicly already in my News Nation interview, biologics came with some of these recoveries, yeah.
Were they, I guess, human or non-human biologics?
Non-human, and that was the assessment of people with direct knowledge on the program I talked to that are currently still on the program.
Schellenberger's information from reliable sources within U.S. government programs studying unidentified aerial phenomena suggests that credible evidence of crashed UFOs exists. However, when Congress investigated Grush's claims, the office responsible could not confirm the information, raising questions about the availability or disclosure of evidence. As interest in UFOs and aliens grows, there is increasing demand for transparency and thorough investigation. Whistleblowers challenging official narratives are changing public perception, pushing for more openness and understanding these phenomena. Do you think the government is hiding the truth about extraterrestrial encounters? Let us know in the comments below. If you found this video fascinating, hit the like button and subscribe for more exciting content. Thank you for spacing out with us, and I'll see you in the next video.